to come. At 5, it's the Ranking Miss P. At 4, Janice Long. Right now, Trevor Nelson.
BBC Radio 1 Vintage.
Hi, this is Trevor Nelson. I was at Radio 1 from 1996 to 2013. I'm very proud to have got to Radio 1. I've got to be honest with you. While I was there, I was always aware of where I was. I never took it for granted. I always turned up the next week thinking this is my first week, because I gave myself 3 to 5 years. That's kind of when you get signed for Radio 1, you think you might last 3 to 5 years. You don't think you're going to make 17. I was a Kiss FM founder member kind of thing. So I was one of the original DJs on Kiss FM. It was traumatic, me leaving Kiss FM. But I felt I had to be on Radio 1 to do what I wanted to do with the music that I loved, because I didn't think it was getting played or represented on Radio 1. Pete Tong was already on Radio 1 and he was doing amazing things with dance music. Westwood was on doing hip-hop, and I felt I was a missing link. I really did. I felt like a crusader.
Wednesday evening, the Steve Edwards Soul Show. Welcome.
There was a guy doing a soul show called Steve Edwards, and I knew Steve Edwards. And he liked jazz and soul and stuff like that. He wasn't really on hip-hop soul. And hip-hop soul was the real deal at the time. Mary J. Blige, you know, that kind of stuff that came out that Puffy was doing, Bad Boy. And that's what I really thought we needed to hear on Radio 1. And his show was up for tender. And what that means is, you know, if you want to apply for the show, you can. And, you know, dozens of people probably applied and sent tapes in, and production companies sent tapes in. But a couple of pluggers from record companies actually called me and said, look, this show's up for tender, you should be going for this show. And I felt the time was probably right. And I applied via a production company called Wise Buddha, and then all hell broke loose because it was really a funny time at the BBC. I just got caught up in a bit of a power struggle that I didn't want to be part of, i.e. people started calling me, trying to get me to go with them, and I hadn't even had the show. I didn't have the show, so I was. This is how it works. I didn't understand. So I went on holiday, came back. I mean, leaving Kiss was horrible because at this time I was still on Kiss while I was applying to be on Radio 1. So I was looked upon as a bit of a Judas in a way. You know, I had to still do my show when everyone knew I was applying to be on. So I just went out, left the country. I said, I'll go and see my mum in St. Lucia. Came back to answer phone messages galore from the boss at the Beeb. All I felt was, this is a drama. This is a drama I don't really want. Eventually I got the show, and instead of being ecstatic, I was kind of more relieved than anything else, but I weren't as euphoric as I should have been, because I felt I had a job to do and there were people that probably won't like me straight away because I didn't like them, you know. No, it was a big moment in my life, a massive moment. R&B was known as 60s rhythm and blues at the time. So to come out on national radio and continually say R&B, because in America, they had an R&B chart. We didn't really have an R&B chart in the UK. And so I was really pushing the term and just waiting for the barrage of hate mail that came in saying, that's not R&B, R&B's rhythm and blues. And we still had some people like that writing letters. I loved every minute, every single minute. I have no regrets about any time I spent on Radio 1. Carnivals, trips to Ionapa, live broadcasts we did, OBs.
Big things back in the UK. Anyone listening on Radio 1 right now know the Rhythm Nation.
Usher was one of my first big interviews, I'm sure. Destiny's Child, when they were 16, 17, came over. I gave them that national platform. It was really interesting seeing a 16, 17-year-old Beyonce, or whatever, however old she was. I would say one of my most memorable interviews would be with Lauryn Hill, because she was special.
When you perform on stage, it seems as if the spiritual side of your music is coming out and breathing even
Thank
more
you.
So than anything
Thank
else.
You
seem like you're kind of taken.
I look a little crazy, right? It's okay.
You know, just absolutely special, just different, just, you know, as an interviewer or a broadcaster, you churn them in and churn them out, but you know when you meet special.
To hear the full interview, download the podcast at bbc.co.uk/Radio 1 Vintage.
Vintage. Radio 1.
The UK's new music.
Are they all this powerful on planet Earth?
First.
Everybody, the hardest working man in show business.
Who the hell is this?
Trevor Nelson's Rhythm Nation.
97 to 99 FM Radio 1.
Many thanks to Dave Pearce. It's 97 to 99 FM Radio 1. Welcome along to the all-new Rhythm Nation, the new noise on a Sunday afternoon. For the very best in R&B from around the world, stay tuned. 2 till 4 every Sunday with me, Trevor Nelson. We're kicking off with Brandy.
Seems like there was sense the first day we met. There is no one else I think of more than you. Can't seem to forget, can't get you on my head. There's a verdict and I'm crazy over you. How can one be down? Tell me where to start. Cause every time you smile I feel tremors in my heart. I have a walk on her. I cannot be with you till my day comes. Here's what I'm gonna do. You should look in my soul.
Station Radio 1.
Lauryn Hill.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
The miseducation of Miss Lauryn Hill. Mm-hmm. When we last spoke, just a little seed. Right. Yeah, with the seeds in the ground and now they're sown and it's like an oak tree around the world now. Many people have different interpretations of what the miseducation of Lauryn Hill is. How would you sum your whole album and the whole theme behind your album up?
The miseducation of Lauryn Hill, it's my personality. You know, musically, it very much represents me. It's this very hip-hop, soulful R&B album based on real experience and me as a person. It, you know, it's not a persona. It's about a person, you know what I mean? It's not an image that I'm portraying. It really is, you know, me and my life. The miseducation for me represents some life lessons, some loves lost, some loves gained, you know, some experiences learned, a whole lot of stuff. But throughout the whole thing, I'm very blessed to have been able to experience it because it brought me to where I am now. And I think that most of us find ourselves going through things that may have been difficult, may have been disappointing, but they were all necessary to get us to where we are.
If you were to record the album this year, for example, because it's such a real life experience, what are your biggest influences right now? Would you do things slightly differently? What would the content be?
the next album I make will be a different album because, you know, I went through the miseducation, you know, so now, you know, there's something else, you know, there's another chapter. It's not about going backwards, it's about going forward. I let the inspiration lead me. I always want to communicate, you know, very accurately what it is that I'm feeling, you know what I mean? I don't really try to think too hard about what it is that I'm doing. Like, I'm not, I don't do music to impress anyone. You know, to me, it's a very emotional, very inspirational blessing that I respect.
When you perform on stage, it seems as if the spiritual side of your music is coming out and breathing even
Thank
more
you.
So than anything
Thank
else.
You
seem like you're kind of taken.
I look a little crazy, right? It's okay.
No,
just jumping around, yeah. Wilding out.
But it's, talking to spiritual, is that a very important part of your life right now?
Yeah, I think, you know, I think live show is important because, you know, it communicates to the people, you know what I mean, in person, what it is that they hear. You know, I couldn't, like, write the music and mean the music and then not perform it, you know, in a meaningful way. So I try really hard to, every night it's a challenge to get up there and express that music. It's very honest music, so it means a lot to me. You know, each 537 time I sing those songs, each time it means a lot to me. I know I look a little crazy sometimes.
But you're not with your brothers, collecting prize
yeah.
now. So
it's different, right?
How is it for you? How's it for you embarking on a solo live performance?
It's a little challenging at first because I'm used to always having somebody to the left and to the right of me. You know, so I look to the left and the right. It's different, but at the same time, you know, I feel so strongly about this album and, you know, and it's such an intimate piece of music for me that sort of carries me. I'm not really looking that much to the left and the right because I'm so wrapped up in what it is that I'm singing.
Talking about the personal touch, Zion, take one track, for example, off the album, Zion, about your child, your first child, now you
yes.
have two.
Yes.
How much of an impact has that had in your life?
I'm very blessed, you know. I think it's matured me a great deal, taking my priorities are in order, you know what I mean? Everything is very clear. I think there was a time when I thought I may have known more than I actually did and wasn't able to admit that, but now I'm very clear that I don't know very much at all. You know, that's what children do. They sort of humble you and kind of give you clarity in a world of confusion. I'm very blessed.
Trevor Nelson's Rhythm Nation. The new young sound of today's R&B.
Strumming the plates with our fingers. Eliminate sounds with our songs. Killing a sound boy with this sound. Killing a sound boy with this sound. Taking sound boys' lives with this dub. Killing him softly.
You hear?
With this sound,
you request this request.
Strumming their fates with our fingers, singing their lives with our words, killing them softly with this song, killing them softly with this song, telling with these words, killing them softly with this song.
Yeah. This is Rod Clef, Refuge. Criswell. Little bass sitting up here on the bass. While I'm on this roast, I got my girl L. One time. Hey, yo, L, you know you got the lyrics to make a nigga go shh.
They heard we sang a cool song. They heard we had a style. And so they came to see us and listen for a while. And there we were, these young kids,
just a little kid,
strangers to their eyes, strumming their face with our fingers.
One time.
Singing their lives with our words.
Two times. Version of Roberta Flack's Killing Me Softly, the hot new single from the Fugees, and that would be my jam of the week, definitely. Excellent. It's Trevor Nelson, Sunday afternoons, Radio 1, the Rhythm Nation, and you're all a part of it. Scratch Dog from Bromley is cruising around in his car this afternoon listening to the show. He also wants to give a mention to Lexi, Scooby and his sister Mandy. We've got one for Mr. Tickle and Kerrin, called us from Froome near Bath. They're about to have their Sunday afternoon bath together. Dear me.
Trevor Nelson's Rhythm Nation. 97 to 99 FM Radio 1.
Tired of living like my days are bad. When I open up my eyes, I'm glad. And I can't complain about yesterday, cause today's a brand new day. Comb my hair and throw some like it wrong. Jump in my ride because it's on. And I'm gone, I'm gone.
I woke up this morning,
I woke
up. I said, pray, Lord, cause it's a beautiful day.
Mother Nature's giving us a kiss. There's more room, glad I didn't miss. Let's take advantage of days like this. And when the nighttime does finally hit, there'll be no reason for guns. It'll be fun, 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 fun.
I woke up this morning.
I woke up this morning.
Even though it's cloudy, I can see the sun.
without the money, without the stress, without the people, yeah.
That was Beautiful Day, Mary J. Blige, from her new album No More Drama. And there is no more drama in your life, Mary, right?
I made the choice to say no more drama now. Don't get me wrong, it is always something going on, Trevor, and you know that. And I wouldn't even be human if, you know, I sat here and say, oh, nothing is wrong. Yeah, it's always something wrong, but I have, you know, I have a choice to decide whether I want to be happy or sad. And I know what causes these things to become better or worse. And that's me.
Yeah.
And my emotions and the way I control and handle myself in certain situations. And that's why I can say no more, because I do have an answer on how to keep the drama down or away.
You're the one artist in R&B that people have followed in terms of personally and musically, because your albums are like a diary of your life.
I am what I am because I've been this for a long time. I've just been, you know, suppressed by, you know, the world's opinion for so long and what people think. So when you believe in what people think and you don't believe in what you are, you don't know who you are. You understand what I'm saying? Because you haven't took the time to realize that, gosh, I'm not comfortable with what they're telling me to wear. So obviously, you're not going to be comfortable in it because you're not comfortable. You know,
It's not you.
It's not you. Thank you, Trevor. That's why I love you. You're a Capricorn, right?
That's right.
See, that's why I love you.
That's why we're girlfriend and boyfriend. I keep telling everybody. Mary, you're going to sing something for us, a special version of Family Affair.
All right, I'll see what I got.
Listen up, it's Mary J. Blige and Trevor Nelson. What they're gonna do is coming through at 11 o'clock, bringing you some R&B and some real hip hop.
Let's get it funk up on up, on up. This is disagree. We got y'all open, now you're floating, so you got to disagree. Me. Don't need no hateration, holleration. Oh.
Everybody get on up, cause you know we got to get it from. Mary J is in the spot tonight, and I'ma make you feel alright. Come on, baby, just party with me. Let loose and set your body free. Leave your situations at the door, so when you step inside, jump on the floor.
Let's get it funk upon.
Let's get funk upon.
This dance we got y'all open. For me, don't need no hateration, holleration in this dance. Let's get it percolating while you're waiting. So just dance for me.
It's only gonna be about a matter of time before you get loose and start to lose your mind. Pop you a drink, go ahead and rock your ice, cause we're celebrating no more drama in our lives. Take the drink, drop, pump, and everybody's jumping. Go ahead and twist your back. I told you leave your situations at the door, so grab somebody and get yourself on the dance floor.
In this dancery, we got y'all open, now you're floating, so
and you got to dance for me.
Don't need no hateration, holleration in this dancery. Let's get it percolating while you're waiting, so just dance for me.
All I want.
Hi, this is Trevor Nelson, and you're listening to Radio 1 Vintage. Still to come.
Step up to the mic, Rihanna. Step up to the microphone. She was singing this throughout the whole song.
I think we've got a year.
Yeah, yeah. How long has that been around?
I believe we're going
to
get a year.
All the way, especially to Iron Napa. Make some noise for Miss Dynamite!
Radio 1 Vintage.
The freshest, fattest, funkiest sounds. Radio 1's R&B chart. Saturdays, 3 till 5. Number 6.
Your boy, this Jay-Z, tuned into my people's Trevor Nelson, right here, Radio 1. Please believe it. I've got a confession to make, you know, I was at the airport, Belfast today, yeah? And this lady runs up to me, goes, God, Trevor Nelson, can you sign something for my kids? So I signed the back of this picture for her kids, and then I accidentally took a plane ticket, and took it with me on the plane. When I got to London, they were waiting for me saying, have you got so much plane ticket? And I said, no. And then I got home, I found it, and she's still stuck in Belfast. I'm so sorry.
Coming home late, it seems you barely beat the sun. Tapping my shoulder, thinking you gon' get you some. Smelling like some fragrance that I don't even wear. So if you want some loving, I suggest you go back there. Day to day with you is always something else. Working my nerve, God knows that I don't deserve what you put me through. Cause I've been so true to you, for you to come at me with another lame excuse. See, I heard it all before, all of your lies, all of your sweet talk. Baby, this You must have fell and bumped your head, messing up my shit and violating me. Got me about to call my peace and take it to the streets. Nothing you can do, and there's nothing you can say, that could persuade me to stay with you another day. You have crossed the line to the point of no return. What you do from here on out, I am no longer concerned. See, I heard it all before.
Let me explain.
Baby, it's not what you think. That's what you said to me.
But your lies ain't working now.
Look
who's hurting now.
Now
I had to shut you down.
Trevor Nelson, Rhythm Nation, live from the Ice Cooper in Ayanapa on Radio 1.
All right, people, it's showtime one more time, yeah? One more time. I want to talk about this because it's this big things back in the UK. Anyone listening on Radio 1 right now know the Rhythm Nation love this girl badly. One of the most exciting talents to emerge from the UK in years. Flown all the way especially to Ayanapa. Make some noise for Miss Dynamite!
One, two, one, two, check, 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 one, two, one, two. Yo, what's up, people? Where's all my sexy independent ladies inside? Cebu! Where's all the sexy man them inside? Cebu! Alright, who loves the R&B? Alright, mic check, one, two. Mr. DJ, Mr. DJ, yeah. Who remembers this one? I wanna see everyone getting lively inside. What we tell them?
Get a witty reading, get a with a chum. My fight on all along like two now. Some let my little cool tongue be already sung. Get a witty reading, get a with a chum. Get a witty reading, get a with a chum. My fight on all along like two now. Some let my little cool tongue be already sung. Feel a bad girl bass, feel a bad girl bass injection. It's a DJ with a bone selection. This one's psychotic, it should be sectioned. It's the range, it's anywhere we're thrown up pain. Excuse while I get into your brain. Let the bass vibrate, damn bass.
Fuck you up like we was cocaine.
If you need your dynamite, need to get the people, them alive and lean.
He's ready to get lively.
And them a shout fool, we now you wait. The recall shock and pop by spin. We got to go something that everybody tripping. They come and run a coffin's eyes. And them a shout fool, we now you wait. The recall shock and pop by spin. We got to go something that everybody tripping. They come and run a coffin's eyes. Get them with a little bit of waste and jump. You know you're so caught up for a fuck the gun. Because back in the day was all about fun. Taking you back, I'm a liberal tongue, my only weapon. Forget the arms, I just chew up through. Don't cause, don't kill. Yes, I'm still. I'ma lick you with a bite that you can feel. Because it's not about what them as it should. And it's not about them advice. No matter who you are, no matter what you do, you can get some of our natural eye. It's not about all them attitude. It's not about the bad vibe. No matter who you are, what you do. And I'ma show boom, boom. You know you heard you because shot get pop by spread. Everybody,
we tell them,
no, no,
watch her grabbing breasts on my tea and wonder why she vexed when you're so grabby. Tell him, please, you step disrespectfully. Tell him, please. Oh, some gal take them tonight. Stand up in a place that my baby Christ calls her. But I'm a cold like ice, try to watch you out on scary ass vines. Man, in the venue, them a tour on raw. Only wanna get a little cool, nah, nah. And I'm like, shock, cause them blah, blah. Nothing to rest, me not the rah, rah, rah. And them a shout, boo, you know you with. Give you call shock, yeah, pop like spread. Gotta look for something that everybody check. Make them come and I run a cup and sign. And them a shout, boo, you know you with.
Yo, 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 she's a real star from the UK. Make some noise for Miss Dynamite.
Here's what's happening at Radio 1 Vintage.
You're listening to Radio 1 Vintage, and up next, it's me, Janice Long. I'll see you in about 20 minutes.
Radio 1 Vintage.
To the mic, Rihanna. Step up to the microphone. She was singing this throughout the whole song. Is that one of your favourites?
I love this song.
Your accent gives away where you come from, big time. To me, anyway, but I think if I did a competition on Radio 1, they wouldn't have a clue where you come from.
Really?
Yeah. Everyone watching the video will think she's New York.
Mm.
Maybe Jamaica.
Uh-huh.
But Barbados?
That's right.
Barbados? How many people get signed by Jay-Z to Def Jam coming from Barbados?
I don't know of any more yet.
And you're just 17?
Yes.
So at what age were you signed? Were you signed at 17 or 16?
16.
16.
But I turned 17 the week after.
Okay, so you're chilling in Barbados.
Yes.
Minding your own business, mm-hmm. doing something very, very sexually romantic or something completely opposite. I don't know. And you get this,
No. How about going to school?
Going to school.
Going to school, which I hated to do. But I met a producer mm-hmm. through a friend.
Yeah.
He's from America, but his wife is from Barbados. And he was vacationing there one time.
Mm-hmm.
And in a nutshell, I sang for him. He was impressed, so he invited me to his studio to record.
So you were singing?
Uh-huh. I sang for him.
You sang for him?
I met with him and sang for him.
Right. Did someone tell him about you, or did you just...
My friend. She introduced... Because she knew him.
Yeah.
And she wanted me to meet with him. Because she knew I could sing. So.
And it's one of those auditions that you see in films, you hear about, but you don't believe
yes,
it happens.
Absolutely.
And it happened.
Oh, yeah. And we started to record a demo. We sent it to a few labels. And Def Jam happened to be the first label to call back. And they were the most enthusiastic. So we set up a meeting with Jay-Z.
Oh, only Jay-Z?
We set up a meeting with... We had many meetings because other labels called too.
Yeah.
But Def Jam happened to be the first and the most enthusiastic. So after we met with him, he didn't let us leave until we signed the deal at 3 in the morning. We had to cancel the rest of the meetings.
That is so big. You're 16. You have a meeting with Jay-Z.
Uh-huh.
You sung for Jay-Z. You just become president of Def Jam.
Uh-huh.
The Jigga Man, you know how big the Jigga Man is. And he says, oh, girl, I want you.
First, I had to sing an audition for him.
Mm-hmm.
And he started to clap. He was like, okay.
What did you sing?
I sang and performed Plenty to Replay. Then I sang a ballad from the album mm-hmm. called The Last Time. And I sang Whitney Houston's version of For the Love of You.
You sang a Whitney Houston record? That's like singing an Aretha Franklin record at an audition. You don't do that unless you're really good, you know what I mean?
I do.
Well done. I mean, congratulations. Barbados must be so proud of you.
They are. They are so proud.
Are they making a hell of a fuss?
Pardon?
Are they making a really big fuss back home?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes.
And when the video came out, they must be just so blown away. I mean, as soon as we heard this record, we were like, wow,
really?
This is a great record. I wouldn't...
Wow.
Now, you're not strictly a dancehall artist because...
I won't even say I'm a dancehall artist at all. Because the influence from the Caribbean and the reggae in my music
mm-hmm.
it comes from the beats. If you listen to the vocals, it's R&B vocals.
That's right. You're singing R&B over a kind of dancehall beat.
That's it. Dancehall fused with hip-hop.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And in Barbados, like most of the West Indies, because I'm always in the West Indies whenever I can.
Mm-hmm.
I love it, obviously.
Oh, good.
Whenever I can. I've been in Barbados a couple of times as well. And I noticed the American influence is huge over there.
It really is.
It's big here, but it's even bigger over there
in the sense
that the first time I went to the West Indies, it was Bob Marley. I mean, like, uh-huh. you couldn't escape Bob.
Right.
You know, you get in a taxi, Bob. Get off the taxi, Bob.
Wow.
My uncle's playing Bob. My auntie's playing Bob. Bob, 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 Bob. This is a long time ago.
Uh-huh.
And then the next time I came back, it was a little bit more, you know, there was a lot of soca, a little calypso
yes.
and that kind of thing, depending on what time.
Uh-huh.
But now, it's like I may as well be landing in Atlanta.
This is why I think we grab onto stuff that we're not used to hearing stuff mm-hmm. that's new and stuff that's different. Just like America and here, like, y'all culture music isn't reggae, it isn't soca, but it's something different to what y'all used to hearing and y'all grab onto it. So that's exactly the same with the Caribbean.
Let's play your new single.
Good.
And let's
Thank
talk some
you.
More after this. Rihanna and Pon the Replay.
Pon
big
the
record.
Replay.
Big record.
One time. to run. If you ready to move, say yeah. More time for your mindset.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I'm ready for it. Come, let me show you.
You want to groove? I'ma show you how to move.
Come, come. Mr. DJ, some funny replay. Mr. DJ, won't you turn the music up all day?
From the speakers, run through your sneakers, move both your feet and run to the beat. Run, 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 everybody move.
Run,
let me see you move.
Run,
rock it to the groove.
Done,
shake it till the moon becomes the sun. Everybody in the club, give me a run.
Run,
if you ready to move, say
yeah.
One time for your mindset.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I'm ready for it. Come, let me show you. You want to groove? I'ma show you how to move.
Mr. DJ, some funny replay.
Mr. DJ, won't you turn the music up? Up right now.
Okay, everybody get down if you feel me. Put your hands up to the ceiling. Everybody get down if you feel me. Come and put your hands up to the ceiling. Everybody get down if you feel me. Put your hands up to the ceiling. Everybody get down if you feel me. Come and put your hands up to the ceiling.
Trevor Nelson with you, your soundtrack to your Saturday night. Lucy, hello.
Hi.
What's going on, girl?
No, we're getting dressed to go out in Roehampton tonight.
Roehampton has never been that exciting, apart from the tennis.
Okay, I've been told it's Kingston, apparently.
Oh, that's what I was going to say. Roehampton's only about the tennis, girl.
I know. Kingston's about the club.
Are you going to the works in Kingston?
Yeah, we're going to the works.
That's a big club in there.
I know, I've never been.
You've never been? You sound really excited. Is it the first time you've ever been to a club?
I'm not from London.
Oh, you're not from London and you're in London for the first time.
Where, I know.
Where are you from?
I'm from Ipswich.
Ipswich. Oh, yeah. You had Hollywood's up there for a while and they changed the name somewhere else. And
then it was Zest. Yeah.
Yeah, then it was Zest. That's it. Yeah, and that's why you're in Roehampton. Okay. Well, you have a great time. Who are you with?
Thank you.
Who are you with?
It's Lucy and Nia.
Lucy and Nia. What are you wearing tonight? What colours?
I think black.
Black. All right, fellas. Going to the works in Kingston. They're wearing black. Look
out
for them.
Watch out. And we want lots of free drinks.
Yeah, and they're fresh. Take it away, Jack.
Smoking that la la la, Beanie Sigel always smoking that la la la, Neptune track smoke like la la la.
lullaby.
Come on.
Excuse me, miss. I'm an you should come hang with me. Basically,
hold up. Skip all the singing. Let's get right tonight. Mommy.
You huffing around with the illest bad boy DJ. Yeah, you know him. Mr. World Record Breaking, World Record Taking, baddest, illest bad boy DJ upon the scene. My man, DJ Jaguar Skills.
On and on, and my nuts I'm palming. Take two of these and call me in the morning. You should see the way the chain harness the charming. Fly them like a bird, like Nelly Furtado. Pop your bottles, toast and scream cheers. Get your two-step, cause it's the record of the year. Watch you, ice creams, two for a pair. Officially announcing this is warfare. Cause back in the day, my clouds was gray, and it seemed like my angels couldn't blow them away. But then I sold my first verse and cop that NSX. But I was still riding in them thin-ass jets. But now, man, my vision's so clear. Out the window of the lair, and I'm talking on my celly. All this you should hear. Listen clearly now. Hello, can you hear me now?
Can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
Can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
Can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
Can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
So drop your purse and grab your hips, and act like you're trying to get this money right quick. So can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
Can I have it like that?
You got it like that.
Girls wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Wanna give it up.
Yeah.
White girls wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Spanish girls wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Middle Eastern girls wanna give it up.
Yeah.
Wanna give it up.
Yeah.
All the girls standing in the line for the bathroom. All the girls standing in the line for the bathroom. All the girls standing in the
Jaguar skill.
Join us next time for another Jaguar Skills Adventure.
Jaguar Skills at it again.
You're listening to Trevor Nelson, 97 to 99 FM, Rick Radio 1.
Whipped cream, dirty mattress.
You know what? I'm getting battered here, everyone. I only wanted a topic of conversation, and what am I getting? Texts just saying, where you been, man? Keep up. Random's been around. Listen, I know Random's been in the Webster Dictionary for like 300 years, so that may count as something new. Someone says, catch up. Random's been used in slang for years, at least in the Northwest. Anyway, that's Krista, Preston. Random is a word of the year. It can mean strange, odd. It's like saying weird in a nicer way. You get me? From Rochelle, who's only 13. That word is so old, boy. Keep up, Emma and Peter. Come on, don't beat me up. I didn't say I ain't heard of the word. I just wanted your interpretation of the word. My mum doesn't get it. I love random. It's a new way. Holly in Scotland. The random emergence happened here in the Midlands a couple of years ago. Polly, keep up, Polly. It's been around longer than that. Random's been huge in Scotland for ages, Greg and Edinburgh. Random's been around for years in Suffolk, Kev. Okay, so random's been around. And? Don't start boasting. I could think of a word that you don't know.
I think we've got
yeah. Yeah, yeah. How long's that been around?
I'm looking at
yeah.
What is that?
How long's that been? You don't even know what that means, do you? That means you're hopeless. But you know what? The music goes on, and I love this. The most soulful record I've heard from Michael Jackson in a decade. Produced by Rodney Jerkins. You rock my world.
The same, cause girl, you came and changed the way I want, the way I don't. I cannot explain the things I feel for you, but girl, you know it's true. I'll stay with me, I feel my dreams, and I'll be all you need.
Feels so right, girl. That's the bird.
knew that love would bring this happiness to me. I tried to keep my sanity, I waited patiently. And girl, you know it seems my life is so complete. I love this truth because of you, you're doing what you do.
For the bit when he goes, "You rock my world." All right, so some stragglers have turned up. Make some noise, stragglers. Okay, I didn't. Then, oi, all right, God, blimey. None of them are invited, by the way. None of them are invited to the studio. They just literally turned up today, like to surprise me. I don't know. First of all, I want to thank anyone who's ever produced me at Radio 1. There's lots of them that aren't here, I have to say. Anyone who's worked on any of my shows, just about everyone who works at the BBC. And I want to thank all my bosses for always saying, "You never give us any trouble." Maybe I should have been a bit more rock and roll. But, you know, and most of all, you guys out there, the listeners, over 17 years on Radio 1, you made my life, you changed my life. And any university tours we've been to, any clubs we've been to, anyone who came and checked us out, Newcastle gets a special mention because a lot of the execs went to that one. But, you know, just everything's been fantastic. And, you know, I love Radio 1 with all my life. Thank you, everyone.